Tool Tech. Brought to you by Cornwell Tools, the choice of professionals.
There is no doubt the part of being a car person is dealing with shiny stuff. Whether it's polishing paint or metal or chrome or whatever, it seems like there is always something to polish. And even though you were born with a couple of natural tools for polishing stuff, sometimes the old hands could use some help. And that's where a buffer comes in. Now, just to be clear, I'm not talking about a hand buffer for buffing paint. I'm talking about a stationary pedestal buffer for buffing metal. Now, I know that there are some of you that are probably thinking, why in the world would I need that? I'll just use my hands and some polish, or I'll get one of these ball things that goes on a drill. And there's nothing wrong with that. Both are good tools. But remember, the idea behind tools is to make your life easier. And the question is, would a buffer do that? Well, let's find out. Okay, what we have here is a vintage copper and brass fire extinguisher that obviously has been sitting in somebody's garage for decades and is all tarnished and nasty and no longer looks like it once did. The challenge is to see if we can bring it back to its former glory. So we're going to start with a polish and do this area right here by hand. As you can see, it's messy. And there is a ton of elbow grease involved as you apply both pressure and a rubbing action to clean the metal. And after some time and some aching hands, we have an area with a definite shine that looks pretty good. Now we're going to move to the buffer. And an easy way to tell a buffer from a grinder is the longer shafts that stick out to give you access to the buffing pads and the power level. You gotta have enough power to polish the metal when you lay into it. Using the right buffing pad and compound is important too. To remove the tarnish, we'll start with a firm spiral sewn buff and some Triple E compound. Now the Triple E is a medium compound that cuts well to start and then finishes with a nice polish. Also, as with any buffing tool, being aware of your edges and corners is extremely important. Because if you catch an edge, it can pull the part out of your hands and destroy it, or it can cause you some serious physical damage. The next step is to move to a white rouge compound and a loose section buff to do the final polishing. Okay, let's see the difference. Now, obviously, this is the area that we just did with the buffer, and you can see the reflection of my hand in the metal. That's awesome. Now, under this tape is the area that we thought looked good that we did by hand. And you can see it doesn't even start to compare when you see the reflection of what the buffer did. And this took us a good solid 10 minutes and a lot of elbow grease. This took just a few minutes. Now, obviously, there's still a lot of places where you're going to want to use your hands to polish. And there's places where these buff balls are going to come in handy. But if you want to seriously polish some metal, you may want to look at adding a buffer to your bag of tricks.